I'm going to briefly describe a simulation that demonstrates scale up a batch reactor. This is an interactive simulation, and the location of this simulation that you can, so you can use it on your own, is indicated in the blue text here. And I've taken a snapshot. What we can change is the cooling temperature and the height of the reactor, and the height and diameter are equal. And what we're plotting is the temperature in the reactor as a function of time. And the point of this simulation is that as we increase the size of the reactor, the temperature goes up for the otherwise identical conditions. In other words, we cannot scale a reactor up geometrically and say everything's going to be the same, we're just going to make it bigger. And the main reason is that we're changing this area to volume ratio. So as the reactor gets bigger, the area goes up much slower than the volume, and the area is where heat transfer is occurring. So this simulation will now look at and show how changing these two parameters changes the behavior of the reactor. So here's the simulation on the Wolfram site. And you see we're plotting temperature versus time. We're also indicating the area to volume ratio, the surface area, and the volume. And if I go to a very small reactor, then the temperature drops down to close to the cooling temperature. Not much reaction takes place. If I raise the cooling temperature a little bit, I'll get some. But if I increase the size, I get a dramatic change in temperature because now we've decreased the surface area. Let's look at that again. The surface area to volume, 0.5, now 0.14. As I continue to increase the size, the exotherm gets larger and larger. The surface area to volume goes down. And so we're close to the adiabatic temperature before reaction slows down because we react at most of the material. We can also click here to see what the adiabatic behavior would be. So if there was no cooling, then we go up to our maximum temperature and stay there. You notice we're not very far from that adiabatic temperature, and then the cooling takes over. Of course, if I increase this cooling temperature, then even at the lower temperatures, I get a very large exotherm. So you can use this to understand how changing the surface area to the volume affects the reactor temperature. And of course, this is a very large temperature increase in a very short time.